Welcome everybody. This is commercial crop loan waiver commercial banks training video. In this training video, I will show you how to fill up form 95, which is basically the information about each loony farmer, about the individual in the each branches. When you land, you would have landed in this home page, in this inbox of yours in the branch. In this branch or in this inbox, all the loony farmers of your branch are listed. On the left side is this action button. There are four options. In this, the left one, the blue color is the option. If you click, you will be entering form 95 for the farmer. The form 95 is basically the data which your branch has with respect to this farmer, which you shall fill. It comes pre-filled with the data which the CBS has sent. So I'll just show you. And here you can see that there is a data already here in this, which is come from the CBS. The rule is what has come from CBS, you cannot alter that. But other than that, what is not filled and you are allowed to enter, that part you can enter. It has three sections, customer or farmer detail, it has land detail, and then it has loan details. We'll fill them one by one and just show you. To fill it, you have to press this button, edit, just below the particular section. Here the farmer section, I'll click edit. Once I click edit, this whole pop-up window will open. It contains the data already received from the CBS, which is non-editable, it is locked. But the other part of data you can enter, like for example, enrollment ID is not locked. And whichever data is missing, I can fill Aadhaar number, for example, below here, or I can fill enrollment ID. One of the two only I can fill. The minute I fill one, the other one gets locked. And here, if you have Aadhaar number in your branch, then you fill. If you don't have, this is to be filled based only on your own branch data. Later on, if you don't have, keep it blank because this is non-mandatory at your level, at column 95 level. Later on, when the farmer turns up and gives his self-declaration, that time Aadhaar, ration card and all we can collect. But the mandatory field has to be filled. Anything missing in mandatory, you better fill it up. And here, either you correctly fill Aadhaar, if you try to fill wrong Aadhaar, wrong PAN, just see what happens. So it says PAN card should be of 10 digit. So it does not accept a wrong PAN. It's better to leave it blank or enter it correctly. If you have the correct number, like for example, I write this, then update. So it will object on Aadhaar also. Either you fill correctly, don't fill dummy numbers. So after filling Aadhaar, if you have it, PAN, ration card, loony farmer, whether he is an employee. Here the information to be given is whether loony farmer is an employee. It is not a question whether anybody in his family is an employee or not. But this data, if you have, you fill, otherwise you leave it blank. So what happens is whatever you can enter, you enter. Because it's a non-mandatory field, then we'll update. See, now the customer details have been successfully updated. Almost there is no data entry, if you see, was required to be done because a lot of data has come from the CBS itself. Second thing, this is mandatory. Without this, you will not be able to see, save. And most of the loan accounts may not contain land details because CBS doesn't have it. This information part you will have to enter mostly. I'm just showing you how to enter. You click edit. Once you click edit, then this pop-up window will open. You'll have to select the district, taluk, and the hobli where his loan land is located. Select the village. The village I have selected. The drop-down will show in this training video. I know it is not showing, but actually it will show. So you will select this. This is as per Bhumi. So you have selected. You OK it. However, the survey number will not drop down. You will have to enter by hand from your records. Let's say I say 12 number. Sarnak number also you will enter by hand. I just enter a star. If you have, you enter. Then if you don't have, that means I don't know how you gave the loan. So it is expected that you have the loan account. Now in the loan account, you have the survey and land detail. I'll write the test. Once I write test, I can tell the dimensions or area of the land in guntas or in cents. So in cents, it will take in cents. I'm entering in guntas. I just entered 12 acre. This is a mandatory field. Without this, you will not be able to save form 95 of the farmer. I save it. So it has been saved successfully. You can see it has come here. If you want to edit, you can edit again here. So I'll go next then to the loan portion of the form 95. whichever is applicable to that farmer, that particular part will come here as a loaning. I click this button edit here. Once I click again, this pop-up window containing the loan details will crop up. Here you can see all the details again which have come from CBS are pre-filled. You can't change it. However, any field which is mandatory but missing, you can enter. But here what happens is hash and red color is the data which the government has decided must come from the CBS and CBS alone. It cannot be filled as of now at the branch level. Again, I'll repeat, this hash mandatory but CBS. So some of this data is missing. We'll try to get it again from the CBS. And until that time, you cannot fill it up. And whatever data you can fill up, for example, most of it is already, you can see, obtained from CBS or locked. So whether there is a fraud or not, that part you can declare locally. I say no and I update it. So this has been successfully updated. At the bottom, when I see all this record information of this loony farmer and I find that all of it is correct, then what I am doing is all the details are checked and verified, I submit this. Once I submit, it will ask me to, it will lock the thing. After this, it will not be available for edit. So before submitting and locking, please be sure that you have entered it correctly. This is your operator's login. After operator's login, this will move to the manager login. Then the manager actually can add it if any mistake is made by the operator. The system is like that only. Column 95 will be first filled by the operator. Then it will go to the manager. The manager can change it. So I am submitting it. So it is asking, do you want to continue? Thereafter, you can't make any changes. I say yes. So it's now locked. If we come to the same list here, it's slowly, see. Now if I try to click it again, next time it will not be available for editing and changes. So this is how generally the column 95 will be filled. Thank you very much.